I wanted to share with you something I figured out yesterday, how to build Xamarin apps with Visual Studio Code for in order to deploy with your M1 Mac computers, iPhone simulators, iPhone devices, and your Android devices or simulators. So I'm going to place a link to this article below the video so you have this as well. But all you have to do is obviously, first you have to have your Visual Studio Xamarin application, so your solution file. As you can see, it has the iOS, Android, and core projects. Okay, so we're going to try to build it using Visual Studio Code. So I'm going to open Visual Studio Code, say open folder. I'm going to go to the solution, to the directory that contains the SLN file or the solution file. This is where it is. Say open. Open directory. Yeah, so as you can see, it opened this directory. It has all of these files here. Now, the next step is to simply take this and let's create a new file just so that we can change this up a little bit. We're going to put our own project name here. Like that, and then I just paste it into this terminal. Obviously, in order to open the terminal, you just hit terminal and say new terminal there. It takes some time to build the application, obviously, but what this build command does is it creates a package for Android and then it signs it with a default key store that they use, and it obviously builds the debug configuration. Where does it build it? So you can just, if you look at your blank.android folder here, you can just expand it like that and you'll see it inside the debug folder. So as soon as it's done building, I'm going to go into that debug folder and then I'm going to use the Android debug bridge, as you can see here in the article, and install it onto my device. I have my device connected, as you can see here in Visor. And let's see. So I'm going to change directory, go into my bin folder, as I said. So and now I'm going to say adb install. And then con.tfp hyphen enter. So it's going to perform the install and success. So as you can see, it installed it over here, and this is the app. So the next step is to build and deploy to the iOS simulator. Very similar. I just go back to the same directory I was in before, and then I just copy this. First of all, I'm just going to change the name of the project. Take that, put it in here, and hit enter. And then it will start to build the iOS version of the project. So for the iOS, the only difference is that it goes into iOS, bin folder here, into the iPhone simulator. So if you right click, you say reveal in Finder. As you can see, it's already done building the iOS version. Here's the iOS app. I just open my simulator and I drag and drop it here. As you can see, it just installed the app. I tap on it, I can open, and you have the app over there. The next step is to build and deploy the iPhone device with VS Code. So similar steps. I just take this, change as you guessed it. Yes, I changed the project name. Just as you have to, and then I just paste it, hit enter. All it's going to do, it's going to create the app file in the iPhone debug folder directory. So I'm going to reveal in this is where it's going to do it. So in order to deploy it to my iPhone, I have to have hooked my iPhone to my computer, unlock it, and then go into Xcode, window, device and simulators, and then it will open this window over here. Then all you have to do is press the plus sign over here, look for that directory. So if you look at this, it's already put it over there, but you know, you go to blank iOS, bin, iPhone, debug, and you'll see this over here, and just hit open. It'll say, are you sure you want to install it? And you know, it'll just go ahead and install it on my phone. Now the last part is deploying it onto your M1 Mac machine. So in order to deploy into your M1 Mac machine, you have to run the same command. If you've already run it, you don't need to run it again. Okay, and then what you need to do is you just go to the app file that was built for iPhone, and then just open it, right click and say show package contents, then you select all and you say compress, and then you just rename it and make sure that instead of zip you say .ipa, hit enter, say use IPA, and then all you need to do is double tap on it and bam, it goes ahead and installs the app on your M1 Mac computer. There we go. Welcome to Xamarin Forms. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed it, and let me know if you have any questions. Thank you.